Howdy again everyone, and today I have a short review of an incredibly simple little lens, the new Pergear 10mm f8 Pancake Fisheye. It's going to be available on Sony E-mount, Fuji X-mount, Nikon Z-mount, and Micro Four Thirds mirrorless cameras, so sorry Canon users, you're missing out on this one. I'd like to thank Pergear for providing me with this lens for testing, although as usual, this is a totally independent review. This is a fisheye lens that's designed to give an APS-C image circle. If you own a full-frame Sony or Nikon camera, then you can also shoot in full-frame mode, although your corners will be cut off as you can see, and also you won't be able to hold the camera around its grip normally because the lens is so wide that it will catch your fingers in a picture. On an APS-C camera, it is possible to get even wider angle fisheye lenses than this, but still, the kind of images this one can provide you are dramatic and fun if you don't overuse them. The lens's fixed aperture of only f8 is fairly dark, so if you're shooting indoors with it, then you'll need some very high ISO levels. Then again, there's no way a brighter aperture could have been offered while still maintaining this lens's very tiny dimensions. Its retail price of $79 could be quite reasonable for something like this if its optics are okay. We'll look at that in a minute. Firstly, build quality. I actually tested a beta version of this lens for Pergear last year to give them a bit of feedback, and its original design was pretty ugly, but I'm really pleased with how the final release version came out here. It actually looks quite cool on your camera, as well as being, of course, very tiny. As you'll have guessed by now, it's a completely manual lens without any aperture mechanism or autofocus system, or of course image stabilization, and it doesn't provide EXIF information to your camera. The lens's body is completely metal, and its only control point is a manual focus lever at the bottom, which turns very smoothly and slightly heavily, letting you focus from about 30cm to beyond infinity. Focusing a lens this wide and with a dark aperture is really quite easy. The lens does actually come with a lens cap, which slides on nicely and fairly securely. It doesn't have any way of attaching a hood or external filters though, which is a tiny bit of a shame. It's a fun lens for shooting on a sunny day, and I would have liked to use a polarizing filter, but then again the extreme wide angle probably might have introduced vignetting. Still, overall, its build quality is very nice and solid, and it looks really cool on your camera as well. Now, onto image quality. Because this is a fisheye lens, I can't really use my usual test chart here, so here's a wall instead. I'm testing it with my Nikon Z7 in DX mode, or cropped sensor mode, which offers 20 megapixels of resolution. In the middle of the image, we see some very good sharpness and contrast, and no color fringing. Over in the corners, we get softness, but I have seen worse than this before, and at least vignetting seems to be under control. The corners don't look as dark as I was expecting them to be. Overall, while its image corners are a bit soft, the lens actually produces pretty pleasing images with plenty of sharpness in the middle, low chromatic aberration, and good contrast too. Little pancake lenses like this often struggle a lot more than that. As I mentioned already, this lens can focus down to 30cm, which is not especially close but not terrible either. The good news is that close-up image quality remains nice and sharp. Now let's see how the lens works against bright light. Uh-oh, a slip-up. Be sure not to point this thing directly at the sun or any other bright light source. Well, when it comes to image quality, that's pretty much all I can tell you about it, to be honest. It's such a simple lens that there aren't many things I can test about it. I've tested a few little pancake lenses like this one, and their performance is usually pretty underwhelming. This one was okay though, in fact I quite liked it. It has decent contrast, low vignetting, its fisheye projection is interesting, and its build quality is very nice. Obviously, it's more of a bit of fun than a serious photographic tool, but it can get you some nice images at a reasonable price, so it does come just about recommended.